Okay, we are back. Laundry has changed, and ham-loving cats are given ham.
Well, at least the ham-loving cats were in the kitchen.
Yes. It's very important.
It is most important.
And Grey Garden needs help, because, of course...
Because they're a garden, and it's grey.
And now they're being menaced.
The menace. You might like to stir that.
I'm definitely stirring it.
Because it's like all liquor at the bottom, and...
Ooh, yeah.
That's where
the straw is.
I tried to give you a heads up. Apparently I was going to stir it for you, but then I kind of forgot because I was like,
Stuff.
Stuff. Things.
Watch the kitties with their...
Oh, goody! Super mutants. Apparently these... Oh, there's one, like, right there.
Get him, Nick. That's right. Show him Jennifer.
Cats do seem to enjoy the H-A-M.
They beg for it.
They do. They beg for it. Actually, Freddy ran into the kitchen and just sat there waiting, like rubbing up against me, like, "Hi, cat mom. You gonna give me some ham?" Because I told him earlier this week, I swear that cat is like far too intelligent. It's worrying. Because he wanted ham two nights ago. And I was like, "No, buddy. We finished the last ham. We haven't opened the new ham, and I'm not opening the new ham until Wednesday. So I'm not having it tonight. So... No, I can do this. He's eating it right now, so I'm in the clear right now, for the moment. Won't last long, but you know, I've got the, and I'm like, so buddy, you can't have it tonight. He didn't bother me about it yesterday, but as soon as I walked in the kitchen this evening, to pour the second drink, he was like, "Cat mom,
I was promised
things. Can you deliver?" And I was like, "Okay, fine, I'll deliver."
So I still say I need to defend Grey Garden.
Huh. Maybe there's a suicider coming. I don't know. Or maybe the super mutants weren't the threat. Maybe you have some zombies coming. Or, you know, whatever.
Green.
At Grey Garden, the price is always right. Shall we make a deal?
Yeah.
You sound like a game show host.
That's the correct answer. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, should we tell the lucky contestant what fabulous prize he's won?
Sure. Okay.
Right this way, please. Let's take a look at your fabulous prize.
Okay.
It was on tight.
Did he? He just gave me that rusted-out Hulk of a car, didn't he?
Well, it's a new car.
Supervisor,
it was
Green.
A new car.
It's a brand new car! Now, if you've already got the latest
in
stylish atomic-powered automation, you can also take your winnings in the form of a cash prize. How does 100 caps sound?
I'll take the cash prize.
Here you go. And if you want to use your winnings to make a few purchases from Robco, we certainly won't complain. Ha ha! Well, it's been a real pleasure. Thanks for playing.
Too
late.
I hope Satan doesn't go up your nose and steal your soul now or whatever. I think that it was more a case of your soul was trying to escape and that your body is the only thing keeping it tethered. So if you didn't say bless you or whatever, then your soul could actually, like, successfully escape and go to who the hell knows where.
Yeah. Okay, so
yeah,
we're
I did that intentionally.
We're up another level.
Who the hell knows where.
So the question is, what to use it for? Let's see.
You know, in Grunt Fodder, I'm going to be honest, Satan's not my problem. You know who is? Stan and Satin.
Ah, yes.
Those guys. I swear to God.
So let's see. Any kill could do more Grim Reaper sprint.
Or ricochet.
Yeah, more ricochet. could also do, not science. Oh, we need more, We need more agility. Wow.
How much agility do I not have? Oh my.
Okay, okay, we're gonna put a point in agility.
All hail Stan. It's kind of like Kyle. Have you seen Kyle? He's about yay high.
Because eventually, Ninja, since they're having
German
sneak attacks do 2.5 times normal damage, will pay off dividends. So we'll work towards that.
No, seriously. I mean, apparently Kyle is German. He's got a long history.
I am sure.
Thing is that he always seems to vary in height depending on who the person is. It's really difficult. I mean, there must be a lot of Kyles.
Okay, so.
What's even worse? I think he might have been Jewish.
It's a terrible joke.
Thank you again for all your help, darling. We won't forget it.
Well, I mean, it makes sense. Think about it. Everybody's asking if you've seen him. They say he's about yay high. It's various heights.
I don't even. So we need.
Say that it was a good joke. It's just that it makes sense.
So seriously, for whatever reason, we're being given the message to defend Grey Garden, but.
But I still want to punch a Nazi.
That's always fair.
Hmm.
Oh, there's a mutant hound over here.
I'll have to ask my friendly German, not Austrian neighbor, Mr. Hitler.
Okay, so there was that super mutant hound.
Das Hund.
Now they're saying there's something like 28 meters over this way.
Well, go high ground.
So for whatever reason, I cannot get this thing to trigger and say that I have successfully
completed the...
Oh, various bits of robot parts.
Ooh, you should look and see if they have anything that's not for Mr. Handy.
I think they just got...
Nope, they only looks like they have Mr. Handy parts.
So for whatever reason, this thing appears to be having issues.
Issues. Well...
But I don't want to just sit there and leave, because... If I do, there's a chance it'll sit there and say...
It'll respawn something.
Or it'll say, you failed to defend Grey Garden. And then, you know, stupidity will ensue.
Apparently, it wants you to shoot some Mr. Handys. I don't know why. Could it be the Rad Stag?
Well, nope, doesn't appear to have been that.
Anything in these shanties?
Doesn't seem like it.
Hmm.
I mean, I'm trying my best to defend this place. Maybe there's something up here?
Maybe.
Do they need protected from?
Careful. Well, now the Radstags are seen as hostile. I think that's a sniper rifle issue.
Today on Deer on the Deer Hunter.
Hawkeye. If you don't flee, I will kill you. Oh, dear.
Aha!
There's the rat bastard.
You have, like, one straggler.
You just shot into a tree. There you go.
There we go. We had one straggler who was just kind of hanging around.
Oh, I feel bad. Don't kill the rat stag. Well.
Well, you look at it. We killed their father. So they're going to be miserable and lonely.
Wait. You're killing Bambi's mother.
Well, I already killed Bambi's father, so...
Bambi itself, so what the fuck does it matter, I guess?
Okay, I'll let him live so he can get his revenge.
Unsuccessfully.
Oh, well, that's not good either. There's an integrated swarm bot.
And now you can't get a shot off. On the upside, Radstag steaks give you a bonus for comparing capacity and hold more Radstag meat. True. And when's the last time you took a booze?
That is a good point. Let's drink something. Okay.
Gwinnett.
Oh, Supervisor Green.
You didn't shoot him, did you?
For some reason, Supervisor Green is showing us hostile. You know what we're going to do?
Huh?
We're going to leave. So, let's see.
Ah, that's the thing about robots. They're so finicky.
So, we've cleared out the Dunwich Boars, and we've cleared the Museum of Witchcraft, so we'll start there.
I feel it's better drunk.
That's
I write some of my best work when inebriated.
That's true.
That's what happens when you sit there and you study history. Because the only way you can tolerate all of it, you know, you sit there and you have all of that...
Various awfulness?
All the awfulness of history, and you sit there and you end up drinking to try to drown it out so that you can deal with it. But you get really good at writing while drunk. Or intoxicated, or whatever you want to call it. And so it's really difficult. It kind of gets kind of difficult to not... To write when not drinking.
That's true.
Because that kind of becomes the habit, is that you're like, this is some really heavy shit, so I'm going to drink to deal with that. And, I swear my history degree has made me more,
alcoholically inclined?
Rubbing elbows with alcoholism. I'm not a drunk, but,
So we're going to Far Harbor because some of our quest objectives have started spawning there.
Yeah, history. Good thing current events never made me want to drink heavily. Let's not go into that. That's a minefield. And I'll start drinking faster that way. This is what we call escapism.
Yeah.
Hmm.
True. So Leonard Moore has like this little bar and grill thing? I don't know. Shop? What's the deal here, buddy? Never been here before.
I buy and sell. Just put up everything you've got and let's see if we can make a deal.
Can I kill this Jangles the Moon Monkey, please?
I'll take a look. Sure.
I hate them. Oh.
Well, he has all kinds of rounds. I like him.
50 caliber. How have you played this multiple times without finding this dude?
Oh, you look at him, he was just off the beaten path a little bit. But he has no alcohol. So.
Well, you know something? It's really too bad that you can't use gourds to make alcohol.
You should. Because
then you
to.
Could give him a little umbrella.
I like it.
See?
Take
you make,
my
you
jet.
Can make yourself, you can make yourself a pina colada.
And get caught in the rain.
No, you don't want to get caught in the rain. That's how you get... radiated, so
let's see what else can we give you. We're
actually,
not taking,
you know,
our rum.
That would actually be an interesting fallout.
Oh,
you know, instead of like the major powers, how exactly did it like hit like Cuba?
Fallout Caribbean.
Fallout the ocean. You know, or you know, Islander. You know, you could go with like the Pacific Islands, and or you could go for the, you know, Caribbean. And part of it could be, you know, you having to dodge irradiated sharks.
Okay, I like where this is going. You had me at irradiated sharks.
That can shoot lasers from their eyes.
Sold.
Yes! See? I could totally do this. I'm gonna trademarked. All that.
Trademarked.
Trademarked. I'm trademarking that now, you know? It's like... Yeah. Trademarked.
Okay, so now we continue.
Onward to battle!
Just so.
And victory!
And there's like a little settlement area here. Maybe I'll swing by and just get it on my map.
Did you ever talk to the family who's missing a person that's the reason why you need to go to Far Harbor?
That's where I'm headed.
Ah, to Far Harbor.
If only.
What the?
Harbod.
Oh, it's inhabited. Well, that's not good.
Well, actually, it's inhabited. And there's raiders. I'm not saying that the raiders are the inhabitants, because that suggests that they have ownership.
Oh, okay.
Bang. Oof.
I hope. Oh, that's the worst thing.
Oh, there's. Oh, come on, it's only a razor claw, it's not a kill claw.
So the, okay,
it's baseball base. It's got a baseball bat.
No, a
there's
base.
Still a, no, there was a baseball bat.
And there's still something skittering around here.
I suggest going upstairs. That's the fastest way to get above whatever is skittering at you.
True.
See?
Unless they foresaw that and already have the high ground.
This is my logic. I have been hanging out with Kerry. Let us rip some things to shreds, no?
What? Oh, you're doing better with your accent than I did with mine earlier.
Oui.
There is a joke I heard told recently that was told in a Cajun accent.
I've never understood the desire to set sharks up with precision weapons. Shark thinking goes swim, huh? Swim hungry, and then if possible food is detected, shred local environment until hungry stops. Actually, I never said that they were accurate lasers or strong.
Yeah.
Just that they had lasers occasionally just emit from their eyes. Maybe they just glow.
Yeah.
You know, it's up to you.
Yeah, I was saying my accent drifted from Louisiana Cajun to Mexican somehow.
Even though those sound nothing alike.
There's kind of a... Ooh, hello, Raiders.
No, there's nothing.
There's a certain clippiness
of it. The Bontemps Cajun accent sounds completely different from Mexican, American, you know, or Hispanic of whatever variant.
Y'all gonna wish I was ferals.
Sharks with frickin'... budget meeting laser pointers strapped to their heads. I don't know that they ever said anything about a budget meeting. Actually, entertaining things. So Dave has a laser pointer.
Well, yes, for given how you pointer.
We have two laser pointers. One is for our cats. That is like, you know, your basic red. I don't know what the metric is for the wavelength that it is. But it's, don't point it in your eyes, kids. But cats can chase it, and it's pretty cool. But then Dave decided to get...
It's not a laser pointer.
This is technically a laser pointer, but in very big air quotes that have various locations, and they kind of extend forever. Because it's green, it has a much higher wavelength, and... It can shine for about football field at least.
Oh, more than that.
I said at least. That's as far as we shone it, and because it was near an airfield, and we were like, "Yeah, we better not do that. We're getting might get in trouble."
Yeah.
What happens when you're in a hotel?
Yeah.
By an airport.
Yeah, you can see the beam. That's how strong it is.
You can see the beam for quite a distance. It's pretty intense. If we shine it in the house, you just see like this green beam of light, and it's I was like, no, I can't do that to the cats.
Which is funny because they will actually attack the beam.
Yeah, they'll attack the beam because the beam is so bright. They'll ignore the dot and just sit there and try to bite the light. It's like riding the lightning, I suppose. check to make sure that there's not a fucking suicider.
No, just these two so far. Just that one. And then we're done.
Boom, crash.
Okay, so let's see. Where am I vis-a-vis? Okay, almost there.
You're almost there. I'm going to be bad. I'm going to eat some peanuts because... Which means I just need to move this away from my face. Yes. I suggest the same to you because otherwise you're going to be... And people will comment.
That could be it, that they're just the diodes.
Wait, a floating feral ghoul?
He's taking a nap.
In water.
And now he is not.
Yeah, now he's a little bit less nappish. I think those super bright beams are what the super stealthy laser traps in this game are made of. Yeah, except the fact that ours were green and purple. They didn't have it in red.
And then there's a glowing one out here on a...
On a pylon. Nice. You know what's really funny is the fact that it seems like that's already not attached. Sniper rifle, honey. You ain't gonna get shit without that.
What's that?
That is a glowing one, Nick. And I'm going to snipe it because it's stuck on the little raft.
It can't swim. I don't know why it can't swim. Maybe the glowing ones just weigh more because of their nuclear material.
I don't think we're alone.
I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, as the whole thing about sharks just reminds me of Terry Pratchett's description of how sharks see the world. There are things to eat, things to mate with, and rocks.
Nothing in between.
Yep.
Okay. Awkward. He was just doing time on the treadmill, according to Grunt Fodder. Poor guy. Getting shot while at the gym.
Remember Men in Black?
Look at this guy. He's at the gym.
He's doing some pull-ups. Now, that little girl, what's she doing at the hood at, like, 3 o'clock in the morning?
And what is she doing with the advanced physics?
Yeah.
Well, nobody understands that shit.
The first Men in Black, back when it was still pretty good.
Back when it made sense in a nonsensical world and it was entertaining.
Okay, I think this is the Nagano residence.
And you know something? I just had a moment where I was going to be like, ooh, you should warp strike over to it.
Because I've just finished getting all the trophies in Final Fantasy XV, which was
Can I give a little spoiler for Final Fantasy XV?
Come in. I know you're listening on the other
before
end.
Before you go in
where
here.
Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours.
Okay, so I'm gonna give a little spoiler because it's just...
Someone has her.
I just found it... We found it hilarious.
So
part of... Okay. Are they finished?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, before you go in there... So... Dave finished Final Fantasy XV, and this is my spoiler. The end song.
Mm-hmm.
What was the end song, honey? Stand by me.
Just as long as you stand by me.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, it was perfectly fine, and then I'm like, this sausage party just became a sausage fest.
Yeah. Very festive.
Very festive. Most partying. Yeah. Righteous dude.
Yeah, I hope you don't mind. We let ourselves in.
Nick, thank God. You need to get to work right away. She could be hurt. She could be...
Whoa, slow down. Kenji, was it?
He's creeping out outside the window.
Me and my partner here.
You brought a partner? Good. The more eyes, the better.
So, what's the story with you and Nick?
Nick didn't tell you? Ran with him on one of his cases a few years back, searching for some sort of lost heirloom. He needed a boat. Things didn't end well. We were double-crossed by the client once we had what he was looking for. I still have some lead lodged into my hip.
Right. Yeah, it's starting to come back to me. Sorry, things ended sour.
No, it wasn't the Hatsune Miku cover of Stand By Me. It was the original.
Yeah, that's me. Lowly partner. I don't even get real business cards.
Right. Getting back to my daughter. It all started with this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive, and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
Anywhere?
We'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you.
You're lucky this is a game and there's only so many places we can go by boat.
And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Don't worry, Kenji. We'll get to the bottom of this. Just sit tight.
See, that's why we're bringing Nick here, because he has a history with them.
Mr. Nakano.
Far Harbor kind of works around Nick.
Most of the things are somewhat associated to Nick in Far Harbor.
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife says she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers.
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Ray. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her. Got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something. Like she used.
She likes toast.
I like toast too, but I don't have a toaster either. Oh my god! Kasumi and I have so much in common. No toaster for our toast.
Anything more you can tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack.
An ear for machines?
Dave, look out, Nancy might be a scent.
Scavenge the ruins of the south for parts. I kept telling.
If that's the case, I'm one hot scent. Fuck it.
Meow.
No more questions right now.
Work quickly, detective.
Ooh, I'm a detective now.
Wait, did I get an upgrade?
I like it.
I'm no longer just sidekick.
I'm Batman.
I suppose you have questions.
Ooh, you're Robin.
My daughter.
Way to go.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
Tell me more about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. Like, shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong.
You said she's 19, right? I'm definitely not going to nail your daughter.
I know she's still alive.
But except for now that
she leave without telling us.
I did.
Maybe we.
I can't say anything.
No, never mind.
I'm just going to stop.
Completely Archer.
Completely Archer. But no, there's other extenuating reasons why I can't say anything.
Don't hold back.
It's just that we've been fighting a lot more, all of us. Ever since Kasumi's grandfather passed away, he was the only one that could really talk to her. Kenji and I don't understand machines, but those two could work together for hours. She started staying in her grandfather's boathouse late into the night. I thought she was just trying to cope with the loss, but now I wonder what she was up to.
That's us, detecting.
Nothing else right now.
So let's see. You know, y'all could have actually, like, fixed this wall. I mean, seriously?
Why fix a wall when you know that you're just going to have some ghoul or whatever just knock through the wall?
I kind of like these project tapes.
Project log. Lamp. Yep. It's a lamp. Filament plus power equals light. I swear, sometimes I think my parents break these things just to keep me busy.
You gotta get a sense of Katsumi's
frustration
and personality. Well, I appreciate that.
I can appreciate that, but I feel her frustration.
Like, this is Kasumi's room. Let's see if she left any clues about where she went.
Project log? Radio. Correction? Working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house.
Put a box around with a piece of toast under it.
Wait, do you even have toast?
Ohm's law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common.
Okay.
Ohm's law, huh?
Yep, which is all which is all about resistance.
Mm-hmm.
You're building a collection or something?
Yes, I am.
How did you know?
I might not be able to recite it from memory.
Duct tape!
Kitty!
Wow.
So, let's see. I might not be able to recite Ohm's Law from memory, but dang it, at least I know it has to do with the resistance.
Electrical resistance, no less.
Which is not futile.
Well, that depends. Ooh. Who are you resisting against?
Project log. Kitchen mixer. Cliff. The circuits are still good, but all the mechanical parts are rusted through. Maybe I can...
All right, everyone. I'll be back in a few days. Was there anything else we needed from the city?
Wait, you're going now? No! Wait, Dad, I could come with you.
It is better if I go alone, cousin.
You know, this might be terrible, but he reminds me of Splinter.
You don't know what half that list is, Dad.
It is better if I go alone, Michelangelo.
Don't worry, I will find pepperoni pizza for you.
That's terrible. We're going to hell. Oh well.
No, we're referencing Splinter. Who spoke like that?
Well, we have to go to hell so we can depose the Prince of Darkness from his dark throne.
Wait. I never said that I wanted to be royalty. At least not like that. Shit, I don't want to be royalty of hellfire and damnation.
Yeah, better to reign in hell.
I mean, hell, have you seen our current nation?
Hey, better to reign in hell.
She also mentioned that some of the ruins of the television studios are still around if you head to the city. Of course, she wasn't too happy when I asked if we could make a trip out there. I managed to repair the vacuum tubes and got the
You want to know why your daughter left?
Well, it's...
You're
this place sucks.
You're keeping her sequestered by herself when she's far intelligent enough to sit there and interact with real people.
Let's take a look around.
What was on the floor?
I don't know. There's a picture frame. Ooh, it's... Something's out of place. I found a key hidden within it.
Huh?
Down to the right, to the left.
Gotta find whatever it unlocked.
Left. Okay, never mind. That was just some gumdrops.
Goody goody gumdrops.
It looked, well, the packaging was close enough to
Who keeps tape. Soap in their desk?
Well, what else do you do at a desk?
You don't use soap for that?
Well, you can.
Grandfather's note. If you ever get locked out of the safe, then the answer is here in the boathouse. Picture where the key is. Love, Granddad. Ooh.
Ooh, duct tape. It's military grade. I like that shit.
Which there is no such thing. It's just color green.
Yeah.
Project log?
Or zebra.
myself. I never
file the soap under S.
Who or what I am, but God. Where do I start?
Oh so my.
I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synthetic people made by the Institute. They're trying to build a place for their kind, where they can be themselves and be accepted for what they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then they started asking about me, and some questions came up. Questions I don't have answers to. I mean, I've always felt off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then there are things in my childhood I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams. I'm going to go to meet these synths. I have to know the truth about myself. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Far Harbor.
Far Harbor.
I can make my way to them from there.
So the daughter takes off by boat, but more importantly, there's a colony of synths up near this Far Harbor.
Where the hell are you,
Dick? Let's go talk to Kenji. He knows the waters better than anyone.
Filed S for synth. So we'll save and then go talk to Kenji.